So I'm out for a walk, and my hair is all over my face. I'll try not to walk around this way. But we are grateful for everything. My hair is really flying all over the place, and I thought to stop by and encourage someone. As I started my walk, I got a message, you know, and the message is, what do you have in your hand? You know, I thought that's very encouraging, and I got reminded of the time when I was between jobs, as a secondary school. What came to me was, glory, what do you have in your hand? And it got me thinking. I had to think. I sat down to reflect, what do I actually have in my hand? Because I had particular types of school. So I sat down and said, actually, what I have in my hand is my laptop. So I got my laptop out, wrote a few job applications, and sent them off to schools. These schools hadn't advertised, they were not looking for anyone. I was looking for a school, so, and the word came within me to look at what I had in my hand. So I'm encouraging you today, what do you have in your hand? You may be at home feeling despair because of what's happening at the moment, lockdown and everything. Just be at a low point in your life and wondering where to go from here. And I'm asking you that same question. What do you have in your hand? It's the lockdown. Some countries have eased off the lockdown. Whether you are in lockdown or not, look within you and ask yourself, what's in your hand? This is the time when you can go online. There are lots of resources online to help you. While you're at home, under lockdown, you can do some self-development. Register on some courses, you know. Improve on yourself. You can learn new skills. Because guess what? There's someone out there waiting for you. There's someone out there waiting for you to come into your own, because they are looking up to you. And once you get up and come into your own, that would motivate them as well. That would get them going and say, if you can do it, then they can do it too. What's stopping them? Remember the story, the biblical story of Moses? He had a staff in his hand when they were about to cross the Red Sea. And by the river now, I'm not crossing the river. I'm not doing that. Anyway, Moses had the staff. When they were about to cross the Red Sea, and behind them, behind Moses and the Israelites, were the Egyptians chasing after them. And they got to the Red Sea, nowhere to go. They looked behind them, the Egyptians were coming, chasing after them, you know? And they were in between the Red Sea and their enemy. Where can they go from here? And God said, Moses, what do you have in your hand? He looked at his hand and he said, it's just a staff, Lord. I can just imagine what he had in his mind. It's a staff. And God said, stretch it. He obeyed. He stretched it. Imagine what could have happened if he hadn't obeyed. When he stretched it, what happened? The Red Sea parted. And the Israelites were able to escape from the Egyptians because Moses obeyed that simple instruction. He obeyed, and that made a way for them to victory, to cross over, and they got victory. Share that message this morning to encourage someone. Alright, one more look at the river. I'll be making my way back home. I really hope everything I said got into this video. I really hope it did. So that's it, guys. Whatever you do, have a great day. Remember, what I do is I empower people. I'm an empowerment coach. I empower you to get out of your head, remove limitations from your head, all the limiting beliefs holding you back, you know, preventing you from being who God has called you to be, preventing you from fulfilling your purpose. So that's what I do. I feel I need to take to walk with me. Okay, guys, I hope you enjoyed that message. Do leave a message for me if you like to receive more videos like this on my page. I'll gladly add more videos. Excuse my hair, today is the wind. It's so windy and my hair is all over the place. So do take care, enjoy your day. Bye.